Good evening, Scouters. In today's video, we're talking about some spooky ways that you can teach your Scouts the Whittling Chip. Stick around. Welcome back, Scouters. It's the Sespy Scouter. And if this is your first time here and you're ready to earn your YouTube merit badge, go ahead and click on the merit badge down in the corner right now. Okay, Scouters, like I said, today we're going to be talking about a couple different ways that you can help your Cub Scouts earn the Whittling Chip. Now, in today's video, I'm not going to be covering the actual requirements for the Whittling Chip. Instead, I'm going to be offering a couple alternatives to what we normally see when you're teaching your Scouts about pocket knife safety. Now, a lot of the times when we talk about earning the Whittling Chip, that usually involves bars of soap. As Scouters, we know that using bars of soap is helpful to teach our Cubs about pocket knife safety because it's a really forgiving material. But given the time of year, I think there's a couple alternatives that we can look at that are gonna both still be educational and fun for our Cub Scouts. First is your classic jack-o'-lantern. That's right, Scouts are already gonna be carving pumpkins with their families at home. Why not use the opportunity to teach your Cub Scouts about pocket knife safety and let them have some fun by carving a classic jack-o'-lantern? It doesn't touch on all the classic elements of the Whittling Chip, but for a Scout, this is more relatable and this is more fun given the time of year it is. Next is something a little different. I went to the backyard and picked a couple of apples. Now with the apples, what you're gonna do is you're gonna give your Scouts the option as to whether they want to peel them first or not. I recommend peeling them. And then they're gonna carve a face into the apple. Now after they've carved the face into the apple, you want to have either a mixture of like 50-50 white vinegar to water or lemon juice and water, and you're going to want to rub that over the surface of the carved apple. This is going to keep the apple from turning brown too fast and too early. Then they're going to take the apple home and they can put it in the oven. If it's an electric oven, set it to the absolute lowest setting possible. And if it's a gas oven with a pilot light, you can just put it in there without turning the oven on at all and let the heat from the pilot warm it up. The other option is to take the carved apple, stick it on a stick, and then just let it outside in the sunshine to dry. The result? Shrunken apple heads. Now I did these with our Scouts last week. Now you can see from just sitting outside that the apple has shrunken up and shriveled and gotten all tight and brown and nasty. Just perfect for Halloween. Now, regardless of which project you choose to do, carving a jack-o'-lantern, doing the shrunken apple heads, or just using good old-fashioned soap, it's always important to review pocket knife safety rules. Remember that a knife is a tool and not a toy. A sharp knife is a safe knife. Know how to sharpen your knives. Keep the blade clean. This is especially important if you're going to be carving an apple or pumpkin because the acids and the sugars from the fruits can cause corrosion on the blade. Never carry around an open pocket knife. When you're not using your knife, make sure to fold it up and put it away. Keep your knife dry. When you're using the cutting blade, remember, little cuts and little shavings are the best way. We don't need to cut off a big giant chunk all at one time. Remember to keep your safety circle. With the knife closed, hold it in your hand and outstretch your arm all the way. Turn around in a circle and make sure that you can't touch anyone around you. That's gonna make sure that you have a safe space to work with your pocket knife. All right, Scouters, so what creative and different ways have you used to teach your Cub Scouts pocket knife safety and the Whittling Chip? Let me know in the comments down below. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and hit the notification bell so you always see when I upload a new video. If you like what I had to say here, share it with a friend. Don't forget to keep it simple and make it fun, and we'll see you at the next one. This is the Sespy Scouter saying goodnight.